Steph the Elf just discovered the floor was lava. How you doing, YouTube? And welcome to episode 13 of RandoCraft, my modded Minecraft single-player series where I do random things. And today, we are starting out in my kitchen, cause today's project is going to be decorating my kitchen, pretty much. I know I already have this nice little oven here, but it's very useless. It doesn't really do anything. So, we're going to get started on making an oven. Also, as you guys can see, my armor is really quickly running out. And my tools also run out pretty quickly. I was mining some obsidian with my pickaxe, and to be honest, I am getting really tired of having to make new tools just to help repair the ones that I already have with the enchantments on them. So, today, we are going to focus on making some of the supplies from the crayfish furniture mod. So let's start by looking up how to make a dishwasher. We need 3 blocks of quartz, and this is different, we need cyan terracotta. How does one make terracotta? Okay, first off, we also need a furnace, that's easy to make. Iron bars, that should be easy to make. How do we make terracotta? Oh, we just burn some clay. I think I have clay collected around here somewhere. For some bizarre reason, I cannot seem to find my clay anywhere, so we're gonna have to go out and venture for some. Is this clay? It certainly is. Why do clay and dirt look so similar? Alright, now that I've gotten all the clay I could possibly need right now, let's go and make that terracotta. Alright, now let's put all this in the oven. Oh, I've got 19 iron now. That's great. Oh, I've got more fish. How could I forget the fish? Also, I've changed my texture pack to Dragon Dance because they finally updated that texture pack. I mean, look at my diamond pickaxe. It looks so fancy and majestic. And all of these different blocks, this is redstone, this is emerald, this is gold, and this is what the diamond blocks look like. I just love this texture pack so much. I think I've got enough terracotta now. So yeah, I have been waiting for this texture pack for so long. I'm excited it finally updated. Apparently it's not called hardened clay anymore, it's called terracotta. But one of the things that I really love about this texture pack is it turned the clay into this texture, which I think is amazing. I really love the swirls that they put in here. To be honest, I could have made my walls to look like this, but since this texture pack wasn't available when I built my house, there was really nothing I could do about that. Terracotta, and the quartz blocks, and we have the dishwasher, ladies and gentlemen. Maybe I should put it over here. Just in case I need to put a cauldron next to it. I really don't know how this is supposed to go. Now that I have this to repair my tools and equipment and stuff, now I need to create something that will help me repair my armor. Let's see how to make the washing machine. I need blocks of quartz, a glass pane, and a furnace. Okay, we need to make yet another furnace. The good news is that I happen to have a good amount of glass panes. Problem is that I don't think I have enough quartz. Yeah, I only have 3 blocks of quartz, which means we need to go to the Nether. And as we all know, the Nether is a dangerous place. So I need to upgrade my armor. One of the things that I was doing while I was off screen was collecting a whole series of materials. Where's all my materials? Ah, here they all are. I have collected a whole bunch of different kinds of stone and all sorts of obsidian. That's why my pickaxe was so frickin' low, why I had to repair it. Because I wanted to gather all the materials necessary to make obsidian armor. Okay, I may be out of diorite, but I am not out of options because I've got regular stone with me. How much more do I need? I honestly don't know. Dang it, I'm gonna need a lot more than that. Fortunately, I have a lot of cobblestone.
Just then.
I honestly never thought I would go through my stone so quickly. Especially all that crap stone that I have been collecting. I just didn't think I would go through all of that. I never thought that I would need to go exploring for it ever again. Boy, was I ever so wrong. Now I have very nearly 2 stacks of cobblestone, so hopefully that should be enough. Now I just need to smelt the stone all together. Yes, praise the genies! I have all of the reinforced obsidian that I actually need. And I finally have a full set of obsidian armor. Now, let's see what this armor looks like. It looks just as I expected it to. Really lousy. Also, since we are going on an adventure, I think a change of hat is in order. While I was grinding around my world, I have accumulated some very interesting hats, none of which struck me nearly as fancy, except this one. Jeremy. He's called Jeremy. Don't know why he's called that, but he is a turtle. So I shall continue this series with a turtle on my head. Now, off on our perilous journey to the most perilous place ever, the Nether. Is there any Nether quartz here that isn't protected by danger? Oh, maybe here. Ah, there it is. Ooh, he's got an Abraham Lincoln hat. Why am I hitting it with fish? That never works.
Oh, you're just awful.
What just hit me? Those things! Oh no, it's another blaze. Dang it! Oh my god, is it nighttime in the overworld? This might explain a lot. Die! Also, I realized that those things down there are not griffins. Those are manticores. Maybe I can kill one. Is this thing friendly? They're little zombie piglets! That's what they are! Okay, I'm not gonna hit them, because I do not want to incur the wrath of their parents. Oh! You are not friendly! Die! You need to die! Oh my god, I have half a heart! Is that a creeper? In the Nether? This is probably a bad idea, but I really want to know what it drops. Doesn't drop anything! This soul sand could also come in handy, though. If I ever want to make a Nether wart farm. Oh god! Well, that's the end of my quartz collecting mission, then. Steph the Elf just discovered the floor was lava! Oh my gosh, add insult to injury, why don't ya? Also, look at how great this texture pack makes the moon and the sun and things. I am protected from falling because I have wings. Also, now that I have full obsidian armor now, I probably should wear that instead of the wings. First off, let's make the freaking blocks of nether quartz that I need. I think I need 6 just to be safe. Oh, I've got 9 now. Okay, well, that should pretty much do it. Glass pane, furnace, surrounded by blocks of quartz, and we finally have the washing machine, ladies and gentlemen. And it shall go next to my dishwasher. Wait, this is the dishwasher, right? I done goofed, you guys. I done freaking goofed. Let's take this out. And the dishwasher shall be up here, next to the sink. Did I just hear what I think I heard? I heard a dolphin somewhere. I don't think I've ever heard them say that before. Also, I couldn't really understand what they said. There is a dolphin, and he's right freaking here. Oh my god, what? What just hit me? How dare you? I am trying to marvel at this beautiful specimen of derpiness because his face is half in the grass. Oh my goodness, I must kill this man. He threatens my home and my livelihood. Oh my god, I had a whole bunch of nether quartz already here. I went down to the devil in Georgia for nothing. Now, as you guys may have noticed, I have been eating a lot of fish, and only fish, because it's my only source of food, because for some strange reason, any other food source I have only fills one hunger, while cooked fish fills 3 hunger. I have no idea why that is in this update of Minecraft, but I honestly find it really annoying. Since my mod pack adds a variety of different fish, I can't stack them all up in a single furnace. So it takes me time to figure out where to put certain fish and into what furnace. Luckily, I have found a solution to that. I need to make an oven. 8 blocks of iron plus a furnace. This is a really expensive appliance, you guys. And I am going to make a whole bunch of blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Put that in and surround it with iron. And we've got the oven. Now I just need the extractor fan, and that's A sea lantern? Blummin' heck, how am I supposed to get a sea lantern? I need prismarine shard and prismarine crystals. Well, I ain't going to a sea temple. The extractor fan I have right here should work just fine. Oh, it didn't clang like the other appliances did. Even though this is completely made out of iron and the other two were just quartz. Very interesting. Okay, so interesting thing about the oven is that it can heat four things at once, but it still needs coal to run. Oh, interesting thing about this texture pack. It makes the splash bubbles music notes with hearts. I love that. So, I have finished my fishing adventure. So now we shall see how this oven works. I guess the coal goes in here, and the food goes down... No, the food doesn't go down there? Does this even need coal to function? Apparently, I don't know how to use the oven. This is weird. Why isn't it turning on? Oh, it doesn't recognize what a tilapia is. Oh, I see. Oh, okay. It doesn't understand what the other fish are, but it knows what this is. Well, that sucks. This was the only reason I made this dang thing. Anywhoosies, I still need to do some farming. What, this is the only bit of wheat that hasn't grown? Dude, get with the program already! Okay, so apparently this oven works when you put things on the top level, and it comes out on the bottom level cooked. It's supposed to do it automatically, but the oven couldn't recognize the fish that I caught, which is kind of sad because that's the main reason I got the darn thing. So, this is where I'm going to wrap the video up for you guys. Thank you guys so much for hanging out for me today and for watching. If you guys have any suggestions on what you want me to do next, feel free to comment down below and tell me what I should do next in my crazy world. And I will see you guys again in the next video.